So hello and welcome to another episode of the Hero Indian Women's League. It is the final day of round four. This is your host Sohan Poddar, and in the studio I am joined by a very special guest today, and she is the head of women's football at AFC and also a former Chinese international, Miss Bai Lily. Welcome to the show, ma'am.
Hey, good afternoon, Soham. Thank you for having me.
To begin with, my first question is going to be, how do you look at the development of Indian football in Asian context?
Obviously, in Asia, the East region is the strongest amongst the others. Gladly, in these recent years, all the other parts of Asia are all improving in women's football in general. And in each region, we see some countries are taking the lead. For example, in the West region, we can name Jordan, Iran. In the Southeast Asian, Thailand, Vietnam, Philippines already showed the quality in the last Asian Cup. And the Central Asia, we can name Uzbekistan, Tajikistan. Then evidently in the South region, India is the role model, and Bangladesh, Nepal are all coming after. And compared to the time I was playing, by the way, I stopped play after winning 2006 Asian Cup due to the serious injury and the competition. And at that time, I hardly heard anything about India women's football and never really get a chance to play with India teams. But nowadays, we hear India women's football in many ways, like hosting our Asian Cup, Under-17 Women's World Cup, more teams and more matches in Hero League, and grassroots program, the school project in women's football, and the Golden Baby Leagues, etc. So India is becoming more and more active in Asia women's football family and having much more to show in the near future.
How important is the Indian football ecosystem and the Indian market for AFC as a whole?
As Asia, actually, we are considering ourselves as having huge potential in women's football, as we count out India and China, as these two nations have the most population in the world and vast landscapes as well. And China, you know, has much longer history in women's football and remain in the top level in the world over the years. And India is an emerging market for women's football. But I mentioned earlier, many moves already made, and we all know football development rely on a well-organized and structured way. So an ecosystem is the key to make sure football can be developed in a sustainable and healthy way. And AFF already made the efforts to make sure it's happening. And I know football is not the number one sport in India yet, but it's growing enormously in men's and women's football. So the future is very promising and we are all counting on it.
And the Hero Indian Women's League at present has slowly been growing, and finally we have reached an extended format with 66 matches and 12 teams participating in it. So how do you see to this entire concept introduced by the All India Football Federation in terms of giving more game time to the players and having a proper domestic football structure for women's in the country?
You know, the national team performance based on the domestic football development, which competition plays a key role in it. And we often say competition drives development. More matches means more opportunity for players to practice and compete. It definitely helps to improve the quality of the players. Also in other aspects, like more opportunity for coaches, referees, more works for the organization, and more interest for the sponsors and audience. It all helps to develop women's football and eventually see the results from the national teams. And I hope your league can be further developed to an even better and more professional way, like the home away format. Duration can be expanded to 7 to 8 months. That means players can play quality matches on a regular basis, once a week. And the home away format can also help to grow the local fans, supporters and investors. Of course, it's the ideal situation, and India is on the way. So currently, we already have few MAs already, like Japan, China, have 3 divisions in women's league, relegation, promotion system. I think these are the targets and the direction that India is working toward.
Now, the Gokulam Kerala, as you know, became the first Indian club to qualify for the AFC Women's Club Championship last year, and the competition is considered to be the marquee event when it comes to women's club football in Asia. In what ways do you think it will motivate more girls to take up the sport in India?
I think the club competition at the continental level is providing a bigger platform and giving more opportunity to the domestic players to compete and show their talents, their quality. This opportunity was only given to the national team players in the past by participating in our national team competition. So the club competition at the continental level not only motivate the players, but also motivate and push our member associations to improving their domestic leagues. There are club licensing criteria to meet as we officially published at the end of last year. It's all going to benefit the players' pathway and their welfare. So playing football can be a proper career for them and benefit their lives from a social point of view and in general. So then eventually more girls to take up the football.
Now, the last couple of years, it's been really very difficult. The pandemic has thrown life out of gear. You've been a player yourself. How difficult is it for the players to regain their match fitness after staying in lockdown for so long period?
I think there are many ways. And, you know, during the last Asian Cup, we see lots of coaches introduce some indoor exercise when you cannot go up for the fields. And keep in touch with the players, you know, to give in their plans, trying to maintain the physical aspects, but also be in touch because the emotion, the mental side, they need to be aware that actually they're still in the football, still having the task and still being part of the plan and having the target. It's very important. And try do much more exercise that they can, having all the opportunities. If outdoor is not available, maybe the indoor facility can be utilized as well. So most importantly is the mental side. You still need to stay positive, stay alert, and being mindful that you're having tasks, you still need to keep in good shape. I think that's very important.
And with the FIFA Under-17 Women's World Cup on the horizon, in what ways do you think it would help the Indian women footballers to gain limelight and maybe global exposure?
I think the promotion campaign is very important. I believe all the girls have their unique stories to tell. Also generate different topics around the girls' women's football and talking about social and health aspects as well. It all helps to increase the impact and attention. However, eventually you need the good results to prove and maintain the attention. I'm aware that the national team coach Thomas Denaby is also the head coach for the Under-17 national team. I think currently he's intensively preparing the team towards the competition. So good luck to the coach and the team. And then I also give you example that Jordan is another country who hosted both our Asian Cup and Under-17 Women's World Cup in 2016 and 2018. And now the women's football is booming afterwards, and their professional women's football league launched in 2021. So it expected to kick off earlier, but due to the pandemic, it postponed. So hosting the big competition can bring the positive impact on women's football.
Was hosting the AFC Women's Asia Cup a couple of months back a big stepping stone for Indian women's football?
Firstly, I'm very sorry that the Indian team has to withdraw after the first match due to the force majeure. And the first match against Iran did show us the hope of Indian women's football. So I think hosting our women's flagship competition for the first time itself is already a great move in women's football in India. It showed the determination and commitment from AIFF and the government to develop women's football in India. And successfully hosted the event was also a great achievement, especially in the very challenging circumstances. That was a very valuable experience to elevate India women's football in all aspects in the future.
We saw that the Indian women's team doing exceedingly well in the friendlies recently. They played and defeated the likes of Egypt and Jordan. In what ways are these exposure trips helping the Indian players?
To improving the quality of the players, as I mentioned, the domestic competition helps, but also the international exposure and experience are crucial. As I also mentioned, India is still an emerging country in women's football, so you need international matches for experience. Also, most importantly, the results to build up the confidence of the players. So pick up the right teams for the friendlies is crucial too. I'm glad that you made it, and it all laid good foundation for the team to move forward. Congratulations for the good results.
And now we saw recently in the domestic league, two foreign players can be registered in the squad and one can start in the playing 11. With the matches getting televised live, do you think it would increase the profile of Indian women's football worldwide? As we already saw, Manisha Kalyan, the Gokulam Kerala FC player, already attracting interest from clubs from Australia.
The answer is positive. You know, the quality foreign players can definitely help to improve the quality of the matches, and the domestic players can also learn from them on and off the pitch. It also makes the matches more entertaining. It will attract more audience and more sponsors, and the domestic players will have more exposure and having the opportunity to play abroad, as the player you mentioned already got the interest. So that's how the player grows. You know, the interest grows and the game grows. That's a really smart way to promoting the game, to improving the game, to having quality foreign players.
So what has been AFC's plan about the club competition at the continental level?
As planned, we will officially launch our AFC Women's Champions League in 2024. Since the first pilot women's club championship played in 2019 to test the water, unfortunately, we couldn't make it in 2020 due to the pandemic. And then another pilot championship was played by the end of 2021, which your club, Gokula Kerala, participated. So towards 2024, there will be another two pilot championships to be played this year and the next year. At the same time, club licensing, as I mentioned, regulation regarding women's champions league has also been published by the end of last year. It is soft implementation in these 2 years, but will be fully implemented at the year of the Champions League officially kick off in 2024. So these 2 years is a preparation stage for our member associations to work on improving their domestic leagues and the clubs. Also, our club licensing department is helping our member associations to working on the club licensing criteria during the period of time.
So my last question is to you before I end this. How is the club competition in Asia in general?
More teams and divisions. But other places are still in a developing process or at infant stage in women's football. We all know US is a strong women's football nation, same as Canada. US has its own advantage, such as the Title IX Education Amendment implemented since 1972. Female gets equal numbers to receive scholarships through sports. So many girls choose soccer as they get great achievement at the international level. So I would say the massive participation provide a great talent pool of the players, and the diversity in races or in reach the player selection in US. And they do have a comprehensive competition system and at all levels, the schools, the college system, and the professional level to make sure the competitive environment. So it all makes them stay in good place since 90s. And Europe is another case. I will say Europe is a strong women's football continent, which is due to over two decades commitment and investment in women's football by UEFA and its national associations. So I just give you one example. They launched Women's Football Club competition in 2001. At that time, it's so-called UEFA Women's Club, and then gradually developed to the Champions League. Now, almost all the 55 national nations clubs are participating in the game. So far, still, it's not happening anywhere else. As AFC, you know, we just started club competition at the continental level in 2019. But they've been doing this more than 20 years now, and together with other development programs. So it's the time for them to receive good results. You know, last Women's World Cup, 7 out of 8 finalists from Europe. Of course, I would say that they do have advantage in terms of distance, climate, economic status in Europe to organize the competitions, technical events, etc. Also, the football culture there helps a lot. You know, many experiences, resources that they can take from men. But my point, and I want to emphasize, is the long-term investments in women's football is the key to their success. You know, it took them more than 20 years to see the results. So this is the gap what I can see between us. And, you know, recently we witnessed that one of the UEFA Women's Champions League matches took place in Barcelona, attracted more than 90,000 audience at the scene. And the following domestic league in Spain at the same venue attracted over 80,000 fans. So this is the future we are working on here in Asia. And hopefully I can witness it happens in your hero India Women's League too in the near future.
So that brings us to the end of our pre-match discussion. It was an absolute pleasure having you here, Mr. Lilly. And with this, we'll take you to the ground. Live action coming up your way. Stay tuned.
Thank you. Good luck. Bye-bye.
Bye.
And just the goal difference separates Sethu Madurai and Kickstart Football Club in the Hero Indian Women's League. And with the surrounding teams gathering pace, it is time for the former champions to chase them down. A win here will take them into the top spot, but Kickstart Football Club are also in the race. A win for them will also be enough to take them into the top. And it would be a big step up for the side from Bengaluru. And this is the Sethu Madurai SI, the winner of the 2019 Indian Women's League, the country's top professional football women's league. It's been a meteoric rise for Sethu, which has opened its door to women only in 2016 and made the IWL semi-final. That while it has given the sport some much-needed attention, the problem in the system won't solve themselves. Tamil Nadu-based Sethu FC.
It's very important to continue the momentum. At the same time, you have to have that consistency of winning matches. And I think we all know this is one of the most important fixtures to this match. So hopefully, we will continue with what we have been doing for past three matches.
And you will be facing Kickstart FC today. So what are your thoughts on it?
Yeah, they are a good side. They are organized and. But see, it's a game, like I mentioned, it's a very important feature for this IWL. So we'll be going with a positive mindset.
And now let's get into the team news of Sethu Madurai Football Club. As we can see, they've made only one change from Crispin Chetri, as he almost sticks with the same 11. Anju makes way for Durga on left wing, and there is no need to change the dynamic midfield pivot, of course, of Grace and Kartika. But it is in attack where Mumbai's riches are all arranged. Renu, Elizabeth and Sandhya are all more than able to change games on their own. And Anju in a slightly advanced role. And then add her set-piece deliveries and Kickstart will be chasing if they don't close down the supply lines. And well, Crispin Chetri has asserted that he will attack and if they score one more than the opponent, why not? He has an intense fixture list to deal with. And momentum will be important to build. Three appearances without a hero Indian Women's League brace for Elizabeth. As Sethu FC will hope today is the day her shots on target turns into goals. It is worth remembering that she already has a goal this season. Anju Tamang is a great option to have on the bench as well. And this is the Kickstart Football Club side. They focus on women's empowerment. It is the core of their football philosophy, which has resulted in developing some of the best talented players playing for the state of Karnataka at a national level. And the club has top players who have played for the Indian national team and have remained committed to the vision of Kickstart, which has resulted in the club's winning a hat-trick in the KWL as the unbeaten champions for 3 seasons. And the Bangalore-based Kickstart to become a behind-the-scenes supporter for the players by providing the necessary equipments and resources required for improving their training process to further hone their skills and enhance their overall performance on the field. And most of the players in the team hail from humble background, and with many being from underprivileged section, which something becomes a deterrent to their following their passion for the game. As Amrutha Vilayat spoke to us before this crucial tie.
I could have played with C2C experience team and the league also, league title also, and we are 100% prepared, well to do the same, and I am fully confident to do the abilities of my players.
And 3 matches, 3 wins, so how do you plan to carry on that form?
Yeah, that 3 wins give them bigger strength and confidence. So today's match we have to do like that.
And let's get into the team news of Kickstart Football Club for this evening. And Kickstart, they do finish very, very strongly to the matches. They must make a proper start though, and so their defense needs to be solid. And so Sweety Devi returns alongside Nirmala Devi at centre back, and Amrutha Vilayat kept the midfield duo of Baby Sana and Parameshwari Iyerum. Roja has scored 3 and created 1 and is having her most productive Hero Indian Women's League campaign. She starts just behind Parameshwari Iyerum. Roja Devi's brace against Silverdale Sports Club was that the quick fire double that changed the game completely. It is a 4-1-4-1 from Amrutha Vilayat. She's got a big task as a head coach to make Roja Iyerum and Kavya click as they did earlier in the season, but she's had to sacrifice one of them, but that sacrifice is their game later in the day. For Kickstart, Bibicha Devi and Pakpi Devi, two subs combined off the bench to create the winner against Odisha Sports in the last game, and these are the match officials. The referee for today's game is Usha. She's going to be assisted by Reshmi Chetri and Rio Langdhar. The fourth official for today's game is Kanika Burman and match commissioner Kimberly Miranda. And well, Sethu Madurai's gambles in the games against Indian Arrows paid dividends. And well, Crispin Chetri doesn't play starting 11 Rule A as often as his South football counterpart Bino George. He does make changes to affect situations off the bench. And Sethu Madurai have not dropped any points from winning position in this edition of the Hero Indian Women's League. And 3 of those points against Indian Arrows, the former champions, have had a 4-3-3 win against them. And there was that crazy 6-1 victory for Sethu Madurai on 16th April when they had 6 different goal scorers. And they continue to keep their place in the starting 11 today. But there are teams in form at the other end as well. Roja Devi and Parameshwari Iyerum were involved in the goal against Odisha Sports and are really looking very dangerous. They know Sethu Madurai are prone to lapses at the back, and they will want to pounce on them like they did in the previous encounter. The two teams getting ready to walk out. Bibicha Devi did not start that game, but she did come on and she did affect it. So very unconscious Sethu Madurai must be, and also be brave and bold. It is going to be like walking a tightrope with one end in the hands of Kickstart Football Club. And Kickstart Football Club's the first football can work wonder. They like to play an attacking brand of football, move the ball around a lot more quicker. And the addition of more pace down the wings has helped that cause. There's Kavya and Kiran Balachanu in tandem. Both of them can spell all kinds of danger as they are in fine form. These are the two skippers. Is Margaret and the number 10 for Kickstart Football Club. They are in green. And Sandhya is the skipper of Sethu Madurai. Riding on her heroics in the last game, Sethu Madurai managed to defeat Indian Arrows by 3-0. And Sandhya, the number 7, scored a wonderful brace. And that game was being played at the Kalinga Stadium. Now this is match number 22. And we are live from the Capital Ground. Only on Eurosport. And a live streaming of this game is also available on the YouTube page of the Indian football team. And of course the former champions just scored 11 goals in 3 games. And conceded only one, a number equal to that of Kickstart Football Club. This season, if only they can even get those numbers or even break the points tally from that season. The bigger incentive though, the incentive of being in the provisional Hero Indian Women's League's top spot. It's going to be the last minute hurdle. As Elizabeth, the Kenyan striker, leading the lines for Sethu Madurai. She's going to be flanked by Renu and Sandhya. Kartika and Durga continues to be in a wide role. Durga starting for the very first time this season for Sethu Madurai. Lalan Puri will continue to provide that stability, to provide that defensive cushion to the back four. Devi is between the sticks. Arifa, Kaushalya, Paudi and Pavitra making up the back four for Sethu Madurai. Talking about kickstart, it's a 4-1-4-1. Margaret in a holding role with Kavya, Roja Devi, Kiran Bala in midfield and also Baby Sana, the number 6. She was highly impressive for kickstart. In the matches in the Hero Indian Women's League, and done exceedingly well in her advanced role. And Parameshwari Iram is the sole number 9 for Kickstart Football Club. She is going to be supported by the likes of Kavya, Roja Devi, and Kiran Bala. So Sethu's clean sheet have all come against teams below them in a tough run, and that must change, which is why probably. And almost an early chance of falling in favour of Elizabeth, the Kenyan striker. As I was talking about, Crispin Chetri hasn't tinkered them. But Sandhya will remember that ARA Football Club, what she did to her side last time they met. A rousing return to form is what they need. And they will have to contend with the pace, trickery and delivery from the likes of Anju and of course Kartika. The last time Sethu FC won 3 games in a league season were back in 2019-20 and they were the champions. And this season they won 3 already. At the end of it all, there could still be positives to take. And one of those positives could be a league double over the defending champions. And so like every other day, we must be reminded in the Hero Indian Women's League that which teams have it in them to make the top four when there is hardly any space to breathe. Kickstart Football Club are continuing in the traditional 4-1-4-1. Yes, as a relatively recent organic development, an actual stems from either a 4-3-3 or from 4-2-3-1. In many ways, it is the formation's next tactical evolution in an era defined by a paradigm of soccer stressing possession as a defensive strategy. And most notably, Spain used this in the final of Euro 2008 to great effect in containing a powerful German side. Since then, and the German has dabbled in the formation to both great delight and great sorrow at times. And the formation itself is predicated on maintaining the all-important midfield triangle. That is so key in both the cases. It's going to be an early corner kick for Sethu Madurai. A pressure on kickstart. There's the ball coming in towards the number 11, Grace. Back into the area. Couple of players interested for it. Keeper gets enough on it. Linthoi. And Elizabeth. And Sandhya immediately went for the ball. Both of them just trying to compete with Linthoi. Managing to draw a foul successfully in her favour. 2.5 odd minutes on the clock. And the first real foray going forward from Sethu. And Elizabeth, it's a free kick in favour of Sethu Madurai. A free kick from a very, very promising area. Almost 22 yards out. The number 12, Kartika. She will look to fancy her chance. As the number 11, Grace, is also interested. And let's see who's the one going to take it. Seems like Grace will be going for it. And Grace goes for it. And a wonderful save at full stretch, Linthoi. Remarkable stuff by the goalkeeper of Kickstart Football Club, Linthoi. Excellent reflexes. By the jersey number 1, Kartika just hopping over, and eventually Grace going for it. Wonderfully taken free kick, and equally a very good save from Linthoi. A chance to cross, in fact it's a low delivery on the right corner of the penalty area. The low ball in, easily defended by Kickstart Football Club. Sethu Madurai continuing with their 4-3-3. Really the central midfielders in Grace, Kartika, Durga got to be very disciplined and work together as a trio by controlling possession, support the attack and help out in defence as well. The athletic fullbacks who support the wide forwards in front of them and don't neglect their defensive duties. They also need to provide passing options out wide for the central midfielders. Yes, good game management of the transitions between defense and attack. Good off the ball movement from the team's forwards. Here is Elizabeth. Quickly closed down. Still the ball comes in. Elizabeth on the volley, and she rattles the woodwork. And it's gone in fact. Bulges the back of the net. And it's straight away 1-0 for Sethu Madurai. Exceptional stuff from the Kenyan. Her second goal of this edition of the Hero Indian Women's League. Took it brilliantly on the bounce. The number 27. And we have an early goal here at the Capital Ground. Initially, Elizabeth, she was quickly closed down, but the second ball quickly delivered. In the blink of an eye, Elizabeth making her presence inside the box and getting into a scoring position. Oh, beautiful, a first touch. I took it on the bounce. And there's the delivery from Arifa. Sandhya was involved. A wonderful takedown by Elizabeth. And a very, very tempting volley for the Kenyan. And there's the touch from Sandhya. The ball just taking a perfect height for a volley. And she rifles it into the back of the net. The Kickstart Football Club, they are on the back foot. Grace, a helping hand provided by Durga. She helps it on towards the right. Beautiful run there from Renu. Beats a couple of green shirts for pace. Still Renu takes a tumble and a shot coming in from Sandhya. It was a scuffed one. A wonderful build-up play from Sethu Madurai. And this is their fourth game, in fact. And they started their campaign with a 6-1 victory over Mata Rukmani on 16th April. And the second game at the Kalinga Stadium on 20th April, they defeated RIFC of Gujarat by 2-0. And Sandhya and Renu got among the goals. This could be one more chance for Elizabeth. This time, Sweety Devi has somehow managing to head the ball behind. Off to a positive start. The former champions. In the last game though, they defeated Indian Arrows at this very particular venue. And that was played at the Kalinga Stadium, if I'm not mistaken. Sandhya scored a brace and Kartika scoring from the spot kick. They are on 9 points from 3 matches, placed second. If they manage to win, they'll go to the top. And Gokulam Kerala also will be in action. A wonderful header from Elizabeth. Managing to work the goalkeeper, Linthoi. She is really having a very tough time between the sticks for Kickstart. She's been kept busy right from the off. Sethu Madurai in possession. Kaushalya plays it into the feet of the number 17, Durga. Durga leaving it for Arifa. Intercepted there by Linthoi Gambi. Bringing the ball back for Sethu. A good game management of transition between defense and attack. Good off the ball movement from teams forwards. And also the discipline wide forwards supporting the midfield and fullbacks when the opposition are attacking. A specialized defensive for holding, a midfielder who sniffs out the danger, covers gaps left by the fullbacks and helps the team to keep it safe. Wide players and forwards can create width and depth to give the central midfielders enough space to influence the game. It's all systematic for Sethu Football Club. It's a delightful ball towards Renu. She manages to keep it in play with her other foot, but only helps and makes it easy for Linthoi to gather. And they need a response very, very quick. Kickstart. They are on the break, back foot. Sandhya, still Sandhya. A 50-50 situation. Her boot straight into the face of Linthoi. And that might be very, very nasty. It was not intended though. Both the players went for the ball. Sandhya just tried to slip it under the goalkeeper. And Crispin Chetri, his team making a very quick start. He will be delighted. Sandhya giving a really tough time to Sweetie Devi, who's been given the responsibility to mark her. And now getting treated is Linthoi. Pulled off a wonderful save from Grace's free kick. And then getting beaten by Elizabeth's half volley. By the virtue of which Sethu Madurai, they are leading in this game. And now Linthoi, she looks all right. The weakness of playing in this formation, the opposition can always take advantage of spaces, especially down the wings. The team can be overloaded out wide if one of the central midfielders or wide forwards doesn't help out the fullback. And the team can be dragged out of shape. And with the wide midfielders and wide forwards having to cover the various gaps that the 4-3-3 leaves, they'll have to shift as a team and essentially work as one unit. This can lead to players running out of position to cover the dangerous spaces. As a vulnerability is visible across the field, and as the midfielders shift as a unit to close down the danger on one side of the pitch, the opposition can play a cross-field ball and start building up a play on the opposite flank. And that means the team needs to once again shift across and protect the opposite side. And quick changes in play can therefore be very dangerous. It is very, very risky though at times. The fullbacks and wide forwards, they need to help out on the wings to ensure that they stretch the opposition. Another chance for Elizabeth. This time straight to the goalkeeper. She is looking really very sharp, the striker from Kenya. And after scoring in the opening game, a goal drought for her in the last two. And now breaking the ice. So much time afforded to Elizabeth inside the box. She had enough time to take the volley. No one closed her down. And getting outnumbered inside the defensive third, Kickstart Football Club. Kartika snaps into the challenge. Zusha gonna restart play with a drop in. So first quarter of an hour gone. It's 1-0 for Sethu Madurai. A win here will surely put pressure on Gokulam Kerala. They will be taking on PIFA, a sports club, the side from Mumbai. And if Sethu Madurai manages to win this game by a handsome margin, that is well going to be a shot in the arm. A blessing in disguise for the side from Tamil Nadu. Which means Gokulam Kerala will have to do the same in the next game. So corner kick here then for Sethu Madurai. Looking to double their lead. Trying to push a Kickstart Football Club on the back foot. In fact, it's Durga over this corner. Durga delivers and goes up for it. Is Elizabeth. Her header had no power or pace. Easy catch for Lin Thoi. Roja Devi. I haven't seen much of her in the first 17 minutes. Margaret. Rolling it down the line, taken away by Roja. Now the ball eventually comes back to Kartika. Baby Sana. Nirmala Devi launches it out wide. There was that appeal and finally being acknowledged. That's Sarifa cementing her place in the starting 11. Pakpi Devi, she's on the bench. She started in the previous two games for Sethu Madurai. So Arifa, she's got a stake to claim here. And now Nirmala Devi over this free kick. She's got excellent passing range. Keeper spills it and the equalizer is very much open for kickstart. Makes a mess out of it, Baby Sana. And that was a golden opportunity for kickstart to cancel out that goal. Elizabeth turns away from her marker. Sandhya. Ball played over the top into space, but Kavya is there to defend. She also scored a couple of goals, Kavya. And a dipping attempt just tipped over. And thankfully, a Kickstart Football Club, they survive. It was Karthika's attempt. That outswing floater. Lin Thoi had to be very aware of her surroundings. It was dipping in. Just tipping it over. It took a massive late swing. He used her outstep, Karthika. And now the corner comes in from Sethu Madurai, cleared away from the front post with a lot of ease. And nodded back into the area. Sandhya trying to beat the offside trap. But it has gone up against her. It's a very attack-minded shape deployed by Crispin Chetri. The centre-backs are the sole true defenders of the team. Meanwhile, Elizabeth pokes it forward for Sandhya. She's gone a little bit out wide, but now people on rushing takes it into her stride. The number 17 and has been saved by Lin Thoi once again. A shot from Durga. Pokes it forward, Elizabeth, towards Sandhya. She was forced a little bit wide, but comes back inside and plays it towards Durga with a nice little drag back, taking it into her path and then fancying her chance. Good save there from Lin Thoi once again. Another corner for Sethu Madurai. This time it's an outswing floater. Got her head onto it. Was the number 15 Renu. They need to clearly convey any danger to the rest of the players on the team to ensure they fulfill their defensive duties, and they must work well as a unit with the two full backs and defensive holding midfield in front of them to plug any gap that the attacking players leave behind them. Baby Sana. That's a delightful pass for Kavya to run into. She eventually gets there with her pace. It's the first time Cross comes in, looking for Parameshwari Iyadam. Roja Devi with the attempt. Goes over the top. And goal kick for Sethu Madurai. And this was the best piece of action from kickstart so far within the opening 22 minutes. Kaushalya. Margaret. Kickstart FC skipper. Came off the ref. So team in possession will eventually get the drop ball, which is the rule, which is quite uncontested. Nirmala Devi. Straight away to Arifa. Sandhya. Trying to enhance her pace from the right. Roja. It's Linto Igambi. Kavya. Cleverly winning a throw-in for Sethu Madurai for kickstart. There's Linthoi, the right back. Not making much changes into the starting 11. Amrutha Vilayat, only two from the last game. She knows what it takes to lift the trophy. She's been part of the Sethu Madurai team previously. The season they lifted the Hero Indian Women's League title. Amrutha Vilayat must be slightly nostalgic while taking on her former side. But meanwhile, her side, Kickstart Football Club, they are trailing. And throw in taken shot by Pavitra. Pavitra cannot go past Lintho Igambi. Sethu Madurai, they're really dealing well with the second ball. They need to hold off the striker, stop them from getting past and give the rest of the team enough time to get back in possession. Another duty is to defend the offensive fullbacks who are confident on the ball and can deliver. Good crosses are very important to the 4-3-3 formation. And they are responsible for providing the team with width. And they also provide a central midfielder with more space within which to operate. They are also another passing option out on the flank. The wide midfielder and Karthika and Durga can make overlapping runs and run in behind the defense, and the wide forward is afforded a lot more space and time to choose what option they think is the best. Linto is throwing. Not the greatest of the touches there from Kavya. Top scorer a couple of seasons back in the Karnataka Women's League. Parameshwari Iyadam. Her attempt was a weak one. Slightly loose there. Babysana. Shoulder to shoulder with Elizabeth. Grace. Babysana again. Linto Igambi with the ball played infield. A run was made by Parameshwari Iyadam. And if the ball reaches then behind the opposition's defense, the fullbacks should attempt to put in a good cross for the central striker. If the pass does not come, then the decoy run has helped drag the opposition defenders out of position. It's really hot and humid out here in Bhubaneswar. And quick feed shown there from Kiran Bala. Roja Devi losing out her foot in. And asking for it is Baby Sana on the edge of the area. Swung in towards the goalkeeper. Devi. Pad is it clear. Sandhya. Got to get this move going. The only area of concern for Kickstart. They do struggle to switch play. And now running from the near side, Parameshwari Iyeram. Kavya peels away towards the back post. Chooses out the latter. And now back to the former. Shot comes in. Here's the advertisement board behind the goal post. Baby Sana. Recently, Hill's partnership with Kickstart Football Club, and the partnership denotes Hill's focus on supporting women in sport and being an ally in their journey to realize their dreams. And the global leader in home appliance and consumer electronics. This is the chance for an equalizer, and she struck it wide. Parameshwari Iyeram. She came ever so close in this game within the first half an hour. The number 7 running ahead of the defense line, just had the goalkeeper to deal with. Tried to lob her, couldn't quite apply the right technique in the ball going out for a goal kick. Elizabeth surely pushed from behind Nirmala. Baby Sana dropping deep. Kavya thought about it a first time and then rethinks. Spreading it out wide. Roja Devi. Margaret. Margaret away from a couple of changes. Challenges. Pardon me. Clearance is completely miscued. Chance might break out for Parameshwari Iyeram. And now finally it's been cleared. Sweetie Devi. Will have to take control of the situation. Another miscued clearance, and this time in Kickstart defense. And Parameshwari Iyeram, a very senior player in the team. And this is how it all happened. Powdy with a mistimed clearance and then a clashing onto the goalkeeper was number 7, Parameshwari Iyeram. She must have injured herself. With that, the referee blows the whistle for the first hydration break of this evening. It's pretty close in terms of keeping the ball, 57 and 43 in favor of Kickstart. Now here, the global leader in home appliance and consumer electronics and world's number one brand in major appliances for 13 consecutive years. They announced a partnership with Bengaluru-based Kickstart Football Club for 2 years. And the partnership is an extension of the company's continuous focus to acknowledge and the determination and success of Indian women achievers and athletes who continue to perform big out silently. And denoting them as silent performers, the team is currently competing in the 5th edition of the Indian Women's League in the top division of India's women's professional football. Their partnership with the women's team of the Bangalore based and behind the scenes supporter of the player by providing the necessary equipment and resources required for improving their training process to further hone their skill and enhance their overall performance on the field. And through Hale's brand philosophy of inspired living to support the silent performers of India, the brand hopes to create a conducive environment for the players and continue their journey and help them and help it to be hassle-free. Speaking on the pattern, the founder and CEO Lakshman Batarai and the coach said that being the unbeaten hat-trick champions of Karnataka Women's League KWL speaks a lot about their dedication and commitment to kickstart style of football. In the IWL 2022, the continuous support they received from Hire is reinforcing both their conviction in uplifting the women's sport in India, and they need bigger plans ahead of the super talented players. Baby Sana looking one way then the other. Linthoi Gambi goes for the floater. Parameshwari Iram, and this time managing to get the better of the goalkeeper. The defender was well alert. Eventually clearing their lines, Sethu Madurai. And now gradually kickstart trying to get the ascendancy. And Devi, she would love to take her time. And Sandhya, as she was the 2019 Hero IWL's most valuable player of the tournament. And we haven't held state championship in 2 years, and that isn't ideal. The turfs and stands are all important, but we can't wait. These kids need more game time to have more match practice and experience, as they need to make those available for them. And surely when you are the title winners, you enter the next season with double the expectation you have, and that much more to lose and twice the number of matches. Parameshwari Iram again, this time a slight bulge at her back, but this time managing to stay on her feet. Very strong play there. And the Sethu Madurai staff intends to use the off-season to take the support of the masses and conduct outreach programs to take the sport to more children's. And they will track interested players and see how they can best support them, be it with kits or training. Meanwhile, a free kick here for kickstart from a wide position. It's an area where the right fullback stands. The in-swing swerve is going to be towards the goal mouth. That's a very dangerous area. In comes the ball. Keeper. That's a very feeble punch there from Devi. Drops on the edge. Plenty of blue shirts back behind the ball to clear. Sweetie Devi. Booking for Arifa. Right back of Sethu Madurai for the challenge. The kickstart midfield so far lacking in invention. And they're begging for some kind of creativity. And the likes of Margaret, Kavya, Roja Devi will have to take up the responsibility. They're playing with a lot of pace at present. Here's Sethu Madurai. Just working. And the kickstart FC players from the left to right with short passes and intelligent player movement. Crispin Chetri did well to play according to his team's strength. Dropping the ball into a gap, but no blue shirt was present there. Now, Parameshwari Edam. Pouncing onto a blue shirt. Play continues. Sethu Madurai. As the catch line, the off-season is not time off from training. With the next edition of the KWL and also the next edition of the IWL, the members of the squad started to train together for a long, long time. With the management working on a fixture of friendlies to ensure the girls stay with the regimen and get some match practice along the way. A throw in taken from the left hand side. Kavya. That's a good ball towards Sandhya. Sandhya with a rasping effort. Doesn't hit the target. The angle was very, very acute. And the keeper also had that covered. Yes, Sandhya with just one shot taken so far in the first half. Chase is on here from Kickstart Football Club. Kiran Bala and Roja Devi, both of them tracing the ball. And now a throw in. Lintoi Gambi. She's having a fine game. Likes to go in the overlap, join in the attack. Clearance finding a Sethu Madurai player in Renu. Sandhya. Sandhya brought down illegally. A free kick for the team in blue. This is Durga. Started in place of Anju Tamang. She's on the bench. It was a big call from Crispin Chetri, showing a lot of bravery in selecting the starting 11. When you win matches, your confidence level is high. You can make those changes in the lineup. Given the confidence level of the team, is the morale of the side is really very high now. Kiran Bala and Kavya shifting wings. The number 12 is operating from the right and Kavya from the left. Here is Iram. To play in the system, it requires elite fitness. The most effective team that use the 4-3-3 formation are very fit and have no problem covering spaces. The opposition aim to exploit the relentless pressure. Meanwhile, they have a corner kick to defend here. Sethu Madurai, baby Sana with the shot. Is dragged wide. And goal kick for Sethu Madurai. And the formation sometimes risks being too narrow. The fullback and wide forwards need to help out on the wing to ensure that they stretch the right opposition and create space and options for central midfielders. And they started their journey back on 15th April kickstart. And that was a 3-1 victory against PIFA. And Nirmala, Parameshwari and Kavya were the goal scorers. In the second game though, it was a thumping 7-0 victory over Sirvadam Sports Club. The side from Goa, Bress from Roja Devi, Parameshwari Uram, Kiran Bala, launching another exciting player on the bench. She comes on in each and every game of the second half. A very, very decent bench to have for Amrutha Vilayat. Still holding on to that lead, Sethu Madurai. The goal coming within the first 5 minutes. It is the Kenyan striker, Elizabeth, scoring the goal. And there she is, chasing this diagonal. This will open up gap in the middle. One step over, waiting for support to arrive, Elizabeth. Playing it towards Sandhya, the skipper. Pavitra. The movement from Sethu Madurai have been sidewise, except the opening 15 minutes. Trying to maintain the shape, trying to keep things intact at the back and in midfield, Kickstart Football Club. They've got the five powers up front in the number 7 and the number 11. She scored that last minute winner against Odisha Sports at the Kalinga Stadium. Both the teams locked on 9 points. Only the goal difference separating them. And now she is well within shooting range, the number 11, Grace. A nice little circle, fooling everybody. And quickly on to the second ball, threading it down the floor, and from an acute angle is Elizabeth. This time gets help of the woodwork, and in fact it has gone in. And Elizabeth scoring a brace this evening here at the Capital Ground for Sethu Madurai. And the former champions double their money here. And having a wonderful game, Elizabeth. She's very, very prolific. This is her goal number 3 of this edition of the Hero Indian Women's League. With 10 seconds of regulation time remaining in this game. And there's going to be a few minutes added on to the regulated 45. It's 3 minutes of additional time. And just at the cusp of half time, and Elizabeth scoring the insurance goal for Sethu Madurai. But still a long and arduous 45 minutes lie ahead of us. Kickstart will have to get their acts together and make sure that they come out stronger in the second half. Before that, they'll have to make sure they do not concede further. Now let's have a look at the goal scored by Elizabeth. Beautiful ball between the central defender and the fullback. She was completely unmarked, took a look up, used the outstep of her right boot and making it count from a very difficult angle. The goalkeeper had the near post covered. She opted for the second post. This is a long range try and it has ended into the back of the net. Unbelievable stuff. Astounding finish. And we have a game on our hands. It's 2-1. And look at that. Beautiful technique applied. And the ball eventually travelling well in air. And the goalkeeper was taken by surprise. A complete misjudgment from Devi. And it's 2-1. A kickstart just pulling one goal back before going into the break. Sometimes a 2-1 can be a very tricky scoreline. And they have tasted blood now. This will give them a lot of confidence in terms of going forward in the remaining minutes. The last 30 seconds remaining of this half. And building up from behind. She's played it out. It's going to be a throw-in. And this could potentially be the last action of the first half. It's Arifa. The right full back. And that's the half-time whistle from today's referee, Usha. It's been an absorbing half of football. And the game eventually heating up in the closing stages of the first half. And Elizabeth doubling the lead and then a kickstart pulling one back. It's been end-to-end since then. And this is the player. She stole the limelight in the first half. Now let's have a look at the first half stats. 58-42, the ball possession in favor of Kickstart. 12 shots taken, 3 of them taken by Kickstart, 9 on target. And both the teams committing 4 fouls each. And only one yellow card, and that was Arifa, booked for her reckless challenge. 12 shots taken by Sethu in the first half, 5 by Elizabeth. She converted 2 of them, 3 by Kartika. Sandhya also had a couple of shies, Durga and Renu Rani with 1 each. Now let's have a look at the number of shots taken by Kickstart. 3 in total in the first half. Roja Devi with 1. So is Baby Sana. And Margaret scoring that wonderful goal. That was the only shot taken by her in the first half. And the other number of fouls committed by Sethu. Only 4. 2 by Arifa. Elizabeth with 1 and Sandhya with 1 as well. 4 fouls also committed by Kickstart in this game. Achubi with 1. Wankim Devi 1. Margaret and Roja Devi also committing a foul each. Now let's have a look at the first half highlights. It's been an intriguing first 45 minutes. Sethu Madurai off to an early start. This was the defending to do for the goalkeeper. Losing her balance and then that free kick right on the money. Keeper pulling off a stunning save. A cross sent in by Arifa. Suitable bounce for Elizabeth and she bags it home. Making it 1-0 for Sethu Madurai. Sandhya with the assist on this occasion, just guiding the ball towards the Kenyan striker. This was taken into her stride by Durga. Another crucial save. Baby Sana from distance. A Parameshwari Iram, a one-on-one chance. Tried to loft it over the advanced goalkeeper, not succeeding. And then threading it along the floor for Elizabeth from a narrow angle. She opens up her body and puts it on target, makes it 2-0 for Sethu Madurai. And then the skipper, Margaret from distance with her weak left foot. What a goal. A wonderful stuff by Margaret. We'll join you shortly. Stay tuned. Welcome back to the live coverage of the Hero Indian Women's League 2021-22 from the Kalinga Stadium in Bhubaneswar. And surprisingly, it's 2-1 between Sethu Madurai Football Club and Kickstart. And we are moments away from the start of the second half. It's been an entertaining half of football, the first half especially. A brace from Elizabeth. And then, just at the cusp of halftime, Margaret pulling one back. And now it's all about building onto that momentum provided by their skipper. Parameshwari Edam, she was wasteful for Kickstart in the first half, and that's need to be changed. And we are off then at the Capital Ground with match number 22. And now we step into another 45 minute. And the league to be played in a round robin format, and the winners goes through to the AFC Women's Club Championship. It's been an entertaining game, a lot of goal mouth action. And I think tactically it is a lot more interesting how they go about, and given that most of them are young players and they can apply from what coaches have told them. With a different kind of style observed when the players walk in. It's positive reinforcements continuously. These are the little things these players will turn into big takeaways. And now joining forces in attack for Sethu Madurai. Across from the right from Renu. A good goalkeeping there by Linthoi. Starting the second half aggressively, Sethu Madurai. Exactly the way they started the first half. Here's the skipper Sandhya. This time she's hustled off the ball. Sweetie Devi. Not having greatest of the Hero Indian Women's League, Sweetie Devi. She's been slightly off colour. She is a player of much better quality than what she is delivering on the pitch in the Hero Indian Women's League. And that calls for a card, and Nirmala Devi. She's been booked. And the second player in this game to go to the referee's book. The first one was in the first half. Arifa, the right back of Sethu Madurai. A clumsy challenge from Nirmala Devi on the number 15, Renu. She is a good range for a free kick. She already troubled the goalkeeper once. Can she do it again? Grace! This time her set piece went haywire. Linthoi. 16 shots in total taken by both these two sides in this game. A missed time clearance falls for Sandhya. Tried to slip in Renu. It's still kept alive by the number 7. Elizabeth looking to complete her hat-trick. Into the melee and then away from Kickstart. Kiran Bala. And there's the pullback towards the edge of the area. Oh, what a wonderful save. Brilliant attempt. And equally a good save from Linthoi. She is called into action time and again in this game. Sandhya looks towards the edge of the area. Picks out the right option in Karthika. She went for that chip. Diving to her elastic right, Linthoi, getting enough on the ball. A corner swung in from Sandhya. Falls for Renu. Still struggling to clear a kickstart, but this time managing to get the ball away from the danger zone. Sethu, a football club and Kickstart ahead into a mouth-watering clash in the Hero Indian Women's League. And both the sides yet to taste defeat in three matches they've played so far. And they are looking forward to maintain that record. Sethu Madurai head coach Crispin Chetri, he's been a former player. He's yet to wary of the threat posed by their counterpart from Karnataka. He mentioned it is one of the more important matches for them. And he's shown a lot of less respect towards Kickstart and said they are a good side. And they have to do better in decision making and convert their chances and be organized at the back at the same time. They're happy with how they have started the Hero Indian Women's League campaign and want to keep the momentum going forward. And that's what he added. Here's Pauli. Leaves it for Kartika. Finds the gap. The ball eventually reaching Renu. Just putting her off with that wonderful tackle was Achubi. Elizabeth putting in a lot of hard work in midfield. Grace, she has been the standout performer in terms of breaking up play and initiating moves, choosing a safe option towards the most attacking members of the team. She's got a very good footballing brain, decent athleticism as well. A very, very crucial player, backbone of the team. And now room for the cross, sent in with good pace over the goalkeeper. It's been collected by a green shirt. A Kickstarter chasing this heart. Roja Devi, oozing with confidence. She scored 3 goals. Plays it on to her captain, Parameshwari. Parameshwari Iram going in tight on her. Nirmala Devi, she got to be careful. Already been booked once. And that was Pauli with the challenge on Parameshwari Iram. She's a seasoned campaigner. And Nirmala Devi once again scanning the environment and sending in a floater. It's crossed the line for a goal kick. Stood strong there. Sethu Madurai defense, but it has opened up. Meanwhile, Kavya. Kavya on her left foot. A shot is flashed wide. A glorious chance for an equalizer for Kickstart Football Club. And that was a wonderful pass from Parameshwari Iram to her right, setting up Kavya. She cuts in and takes it onto her left foot. Just couldn't hit the target. Baby Sana. Linthoi. Margaret. Outnumbered in midfield. Achubi. Roja Devi. Baby Sana again. And then taking the aerial route. And eventually nothing comes out of that move. Chubby holds it up. An angle ball towards Sana. I can't keep this step up at present. Sethu Madurai. A beautiful pressure exerted by Kickstart Football Club. Has been the best spell in this game so far. A lot of giveaways in the middle of the park as well from both the teams. She has been the primary supply line for Kickstart in this competition so far. But baby Sana, not at her very best this evening. And even though 35 minutes still remaining, a long, long way to go. Only a one goal separating the two teams. And now charging down the left. Sandhya, and eventually the right back gets there first. And there's the room for the cross, and not in play. Crispin Chetri is really happy with the way his team has performed. But it's been given away to Elizabeth and towards Sandhya. A biting challenge from Sweetie Devi. Sensing the danger. Going all out for the ball. Lining it up from distance. Easily gathered by Linthoi. Kickstart showing a lot of character over the last 10 minutes, seeing more of the ball. And suddenly Sethu Madurai, they're on the back foot. And this was Elizabeth looking to set up the number 7, the skipper Sandhya. And Anju Tamang, as we can see, regular starter for Sethu Madurai. And this game she's been kept on the bench. And Amrutha Vilayat, the head coach of Kickstart, still thinking what are the areas they need to improve, the players available at her disposal. Maybe she could opt for a more attacking option. She's got a few of them on the bench. Sushmita Lepcha could be a very handy move. The number 8. Anjali Chanu as well. Brings it down, Pavitra. Durga. Another long ball headed away by Nirmala Devi. Baby Sana gets caught in possession. And this might be a chance for Elizabeth. She rounds the keeper. The angle is very, very difficult. And throw in goes against Sethu Madurai. And Elizabeth is unhappy. Linthoi Gambi. Just at the hour mark here at the Capital Ground, it's still 2-1 in favor of Sethu Madurai. In case you've just joined us, All the three goals have been scored in the first half, nothing so far in the second. Yes, Kickstart Football Club eyeing for comeback. This will be shielded out. Well done there by Pauri. Just stopping the ball from going out. Kickstart. There's the cross in from Kavya. And not a bad ball either. Roja Devi was ready. Breathing down the necks of Kaushalya. And corner kick for Kickstart. Having the Lions' share of possession. A Kickstart Football Club. But they got to make this particular chance count here. And the delivery is from the set piece. Has gone slightly off the mark. And Kavya will take it. In swing floater. Into the top netting. She tried to score an Olympic goal. She tried to score directly from corner. She's got the potential to do so. A mean left foot. A mistake by the Sethu Madurai defense. And almost capitalized by the team in green. Kickstart. A comeback was there on the cards. Kavya again, Parameshwari Idam. She got to look towards the right. It goes the other way around. And finds Anjali. Kiran Bala. And she is offside. And just marginally offside, the number 12. Kickstart Football Club, on the other hand, are also in decent form. And they have won each of their first three Hero Indian Women's League matches. Speaking about the game against Sethu FC, Amrutha Vilayat stated that they are playing against Sethu. They are an experienced team and they have won the league. They have to give their 100% and they are prepared well to do the same. And really confident in the abilities of the team. Aziram. Attempted pass is quickly blocked. And Gokulam Kerala will be watching this and hoping for a draw. And momentarily, they will see their place. Gokulam Kerala will be slipping down. By one spot to second. And of course, chance for them to regain that spot once they take on PIFA. So far, it has been a smooth sailing for Gokulam in this competition. A change is getting ready for Sethu Madurai. Is going to be the number 10, Mariammal, who will come on. She scored against Mata Rukmani in that 6-1 victory. Surprisingly, Sethu Madurai, they've had 6 different goal scorers. And always refreshing to see when you have scorers all across the pitch. Let's see whether Mariammal can make any impact in this game. And the ball kept in play, is stopping it from going out and then delivering the cross. Eventually it's a corner kick. Oh, there is Sweetie Devi. She's had a really difficult outing. Sometimes those lapses in defense causing them. They conceded just one goal, and before this game they conceded two, in fact this evening, and that takes their tally to three with 26 minutes still remaining. A chance to counter for kickstart. The long ball. Little defender getting in the way, and now, and off the ball, a tussle going on between Pawdy and Roja Devi. And got to be careful, just, you cannot afford to lose your cool. And Roja Devi, as their side is trailing, and they got to keep a calm head and approach this game. They need to keep the focus for the remaining minutes and try and convert even the half chances. Now there's the ball coming in, and out it goes. She's got wonderful ability to pass under pressure, Baby Sana, which makes her so exciting player to watch. And every time Kickstart Football Club struggling to find a release point in midfield, and just playing the ball towards the number 6, Baby Sana, and she can get them out of any tight situation. And look at that pass, completely breaking the lines. Parameshwari Idam riding the challenge, opting to go short towards Baby Sana. Sweetie Devi looking for that crossfield ball, taking a tumble, a kickstart player. A referee says get up. Now it's gonna be cleared by Nirmala Devi. Throw-in gonna be taken by Arifa, just cementing her place into the playing 11. Pakpi Devi is usually the club's first choice right back. As the Kickstart Football Club, they focus on women's empowerment is the core of the football club's philosophy, and it has resulted into developing some of the best talented players for the state of Karnataka at a national level. Six players so far, and the club has top players who have played for the Indian national women's team and have remained committed to the vision of Kickstart, which has resulted into the club winning a hat-trick of Karnataka Women League as the unbeaten champion for 3 years. It's a wonderful record to have. We saw their men's team play in the Bangalore Super Division recently in the month of December last year. Now hot on the heels of Linthoi Gambi. The referee just blowing the whistle for a foul. Just asking her to calm down. Free kick for Sethu Madurai. This is the seventh foul committed by Kickstart in this game. And free kick from this sort of an area can really cause a lot of issues. It's Kartika. She will be taking it. It's a right location of delivery. Knocked back towards the back post. Too high for Elizabeth. The idea was right. Just tried to head it across the face of goal. Sandhya. Towards Elizabeth. She was waiting at the back post. Margaret, she might have a free run here. Takes no chance. Makes a long clearance, Kavya. A Sethu Madurai player is down. But play continues, Kavya. Into the channel. Comes back in towards Roja Devi. Beautiful disguise towards Parmeshwar Iram. A play called back because Elizabeth is injured. Still getting treated, Elizabeth. Two brilliant goals in the first half, proving to be the difference maker. This is Amrutha Vilayat, the head coach of Kickstart. She knows her side is still very much into this game. Slightly limping. It's turning out to be an exciting battle between the two African strikers as well, El Chadai of Gokulam, Kerala, and Elizabeth of Sethu Madurai. And El Chadai will be in action a couple of hours from now on at the Kalinga Stadium against PIFA Football Club. Bibicha Devi comes on for Kiran Balachanu. She has a like for like change. Bibicha Devi, she's been used as a sub in each and every game by Amrutha Vilayat. And the Kickstart FC head coach up against her former side with her trusted lieutenants this time. There's Kavya. The play gonna resume. This is Devi with the goal kick headed on. Just far too ahead of Sandhya. A clearance from Kickstart. Getting her body in the way of the ball and the man. The number 6, Baby Sana. Excellent technique applied. We approach the last 15 minutes of this game. There's going to be another change. And Kavya will be going off
And coming in is Pakpi Devi, the right back, which means Sarifa. Linthoi Gambi, she will have the advantage too. Play slightly higher up the pitch. Kickstart Football Club building up from the far side. And number 23, here comes on Sunita Sarkar. She is a central midfielder, Sunita. Coming in place of Elizabeth. She had to be taken off due to that knock. Slightly unfortunate for Sethu Madurai. Going to have an eye on their approach. Whether they're going to sit back and defend and try and protect this leader. Go all out in search of the third goal. Because their trusted striker is out with an injury. This will allow a kickstart the freedom to commit men, to commit women in attack. And once again, the goalkeeper had to come out a long way to make the clearance. Now into the box, trying to set up Durga. Clearance from Pakpi Devi. Almost lost it there. Roja Devi going down. Spared the blushes. There's that high interception from Margaret. Roja Devi asking for it. And the relay released towards her slightly late, and now it opened up for the number 14. It was a fine chance for Bibicha. Iram is offside. The last match for Sethu Madurai has boosted the morale of the team. They are looking to keep up the momentum and stay on top with a win this evening. Kickstart just sneaking in. A last minute goal against Odisha Sports. Bibicha, Roja Devi, Bibicha making her way into the box. Roja Devi, first time cross not allowed, still looking for room to cross it in once again. It's cleared out for a corner. It's been a football fest going on at present in India. Three tournaments running simultaneously. The Hero I League in West Bengal, and the Hero Indian Women's League in Bhubaneswar, and the Santosh Trophy in Kerala, and also the Reliance Development League in South Goa. Tonight is the first semi-final of the 75th edition of Santosh Trophy. Kerala taking on Karnataka. The home team will be in action. And tomorrow, Bengal are going to be taking on Manipur. Two lip-smacking encounters. Coming up for the Indian football fans. Sweetie Devi, cushioning it towards Linthoi. Pakpi, a nice exchange. Pakpi keeps going. Continuing her run is Parameshwar Iram. A very strong challenge from Pody. And only in physic, Parameshwar Iram, she lacks slightly, trying to get away from Arifa. She's a very skillful player, Parameshwar Iram. Only lacks in strength, but with the ball at her feet, she's got a lot of flair and trickery up her sleeves. And now Sethu Madurai got to get the marking right inside the box. Last 10 minutes of regulation time remaining in this game. Ball delivered towards the far side. Header comes in. Was looking for a guide on from Parameshwari. He's arguing with the assistant referee. Just trying to say the last touch came off a blue shirt. It was another corner. The referee not paying any heed to her appeal. Taken away by Sandhya. Sandhya away from one. Sandhya's ball into the box. A poor first touch, slightly had to go behind. And then Mariammal. She was forced out of the area. Parameshwar Iram. The pressure going to be applied from the right hand side. A player is marauding down the right in Bibicha Devi. Throw in taken shot. Looking for Parameshwar Iram too soon. Time ticking away for kickstart. It's been a game between two evenly matched side. It's turning out to be a very close contest so far. She will take her time, though, Devi. So a lot of passing options and angles for the players on the ball. And due to the focus on the movement and shape, the player on the ball should always have a number of options available to them, and this in turn helps the team to dominate possession, pressure the opposition into mistakes due to the high energy nature of the formation and the number of players pushing up the field. And it is possibly to force the opponents into mistakes by limiting their time on the ball and the space that they receive it. And off the ball movement confuses the opposition and the flexible nature. One more change from kickstart. Lomching comes on. Amrutha Vilayat playing her card. Bibicha snatched away by her. Parameshwari, nice touch and turn. The ball comes out to a Spakpi Devi, Roja Devi now. She's got the number 4 Pavitra to deal with. And still Roja Devi. There was a challenge on her. Managing to stay on her feet somehow. Overplays it.
pressurizing the opposition into mistakes due to the high energy nature of the formation and number of players pushing up the field. It is possible to force the opponents into mistake by limiting their time on the ball and the space that they receive. An off-the-ball movement confuses the opposition. The flexible nature of 4-3-3 formation means that the interchanging forward line, the different runs that the players make, can create havoc amongst the opposition, who are the unsure of who to mark. And this is Lomching. Kartika releasing Sandhya. There's the low cross away by Nirmala Devi. Linthoi Gambi. Lomching. It's gone out for another throw-in. The tempo of the game, the pace of the game has reduced. Especially with tired legs around. A fresh pair of legs injected by both the managers. And not a very proper clearance from Nirmala. Taking her time in going forward, Pavitra. She will be taking the throw in and in that bargain try and steal a few important seconds. Flicks it over. Her marker. Shot was there. Met with the air in the end. Sweetie Devi. Parameshwari. Slightly heavy touch. And pouncing onto it. Pavitra. Excellent tracking back. Crispin Chetri. Looking on intently. Margaret, can she provide another moment of magic here? Nirmala Devi. The ball just eluding the number 11. Roja Devi. She is hovering around. A tackle from behind. Dispossessed of the ball. Durga. And kickstart. Looking to rush forward. Not much time remaining in this game. One moment of magic can bring back kickstart into this match. There's a very clever pass for Pakpi Devi. And in comes the number 14. She steps in, Bivicha. Margaret. The 1-2. Just not coming out. Sweetie Devi, she's been given the responsibility to mark Sethu Madurai's number 10, which is why she came that far out.
looking to put the game to bed. Sethu Madurai, but the intensity and their passing is slightly missing. And the card is out. It's going to be another booking. It's going to be 4 minutes of additional time. That was the booking for Linthoi Gambi, the number 3 and the second kickstart player. But to go to the referee's book, she brought down Sandhya without a shadow of a doubt. That calls for a card. Crispin Chetri, last minute instruction. Will look to take their time with set pieces. Kartika. Training ground trick. This time a low cross and almost turned into her own goal by Sweetie. Very lucky it stayed out. A corner kick for Sethu Madurai, corner number 8. Kartika delivers into the box, keeper punches it clear. Pakpi Devi. She lost sight of the ball and now it's with Sethu Madurai jumping over the challenge and now sidestepping past. Durga not allowed to turn. What a ball! Out wide! The offside flag already went up. And now Anju Tamang will be summoned by Crispin Chetri in this game, and Durga will make way for the India international. A clever change made by Crispin Chetri, trying to just run down the clock. Sweetie Devi. Nirmala striding out of defense. Achubi. Margaret. Anju Tamang, her first touch. And what a ball! Too much quality in that pass. Sandhya looking for that first time release for Anju. With a very crucial intervention there. Linthoi Gambi. And this might be the equalizer for kickstart. Roja Devi just cannot go past the goalkeeper. The keeper is nowhere near. The chance is still alive for kickstart, and now giving too much time to Sethu Madurai to arrange their defense. A chance for a cross and it comes. Pakpi Devi with the ball in. Devi collects it with authority. So that's the full time whistle. And Sethu Madurai winning this game by a very narrow margin. It was a very evenly contested game. And this win taking the former champions to the top of the points table.
4 wins in a row for the side from Tamil Nadu. Only conceded 2 goals so far in 4 matches and scored 13. It was a collective effort put in by Sethu Madurai. A kick start. They really worked hard in the second half, but things didn't go their way. Even though Roja Devi had a chance in the dying minutes to bring back her side on level terms, Devi just coming out too strong. Today's hero of the match is going to be Elizabeth, the Kenyan striker of Sethu Madurai, for scoring a wonderful brace. And there she is, slightly limping, looks like an ankle injury. And now she is posing with a check of 5,000 rupees, powered by Hero Motocorp Limited. And that's the full-time scoreline from the capital ground. Is Sethu Football Club 2, Kickstart Football Club 1. These are the match stats. A Kickstart ahead in ball possession, but Sethu Madurai making their chances count. 17 shots taken, 11 of them on target. That speaks volumes about their wealth in attack. Sethu Madurai in this game, 5 by Elizabeth, Karthika with 4, Durga with 3, Sandhya with 2, Mariyammal, Grace and Renu Rani with 1 each. And these are the number of shots taken by Kickstart, 2 by Parameshwari Devi, Roja Devi, and Grace, and Baby Sana and Kavya with 1 shot each. Now we will have a look at the number of fouls committed in this game by Sethu Madurai. 5 fouls in total. Arifa with 2, Elizabeth with 1, Paudi with 1, Sandhya as well. And now we will quickly move on to the number of fouls committed by Kickstart Football Club. 10 in total. Parameshwari Iram Devi with 2. Lingthoi Gambi with 3. She was also booked. Bibicha Devi, the newcomer, she came on as in the second half as a change. Rosa Devi also committing 1 foul in this game. Now let's have a look at the match at the capital ground. It was a 3:30 p.m. kickoff. This was the free kick wonderfully taken. A brilliant save as well from Lintoy. A cross from Arifa. This was the opening goal scored by Elizabeth. A cross from the right hand side delivered by Arifa. And making no mistake, Elizabeth, in making it 1-0, and then watch out for her celebration. This was another attempt. Keeper was on hand to save it at a near post. Parameshwari Edum with a one-on-one chance. She just couldn't finish it off. And on the half turn, Baby Sana shooting it wide. Beautiful ball slipping in. Elizabeth opens up her body and bangs it in just at the stroke of half time, making it 2-0 for Sethu Madurai. and then Margaret pulling one back before going into the break, and that did give some light of hope, some glimmer of hope to the Kickstart Football Club side. Well, the second half was limited of chances, but this was the wonderful save from Lin Thoido, and Kavya with a chance as well. Not quite hitting the target from the corner. Attempted header, looking for that flip.